Well, tonight we are learning the skydiver who died yesterday afternoon near Lodi may have had a problem deploying his parachute. That's what his friend and officials with the U.S. Parachute Association believe so far.
The victim was identified this morning as 42-year-old Matthew Ciancio of June Lake. CBS 13's Angela Musalem is live in Ocampo with more on what could have caused his death. Angela?
Yeah, Sam, Adrian, the speculation right now is the victim may have packed his parachute the wrong way or even deployed it too late after his jump. His friend, also a skydiver, says unfortunately, death is a risk many skydivers are willing to take. The skies bring euphoria to many skydivers, but on Wednesday, the adrenaline-pumping sport took the life of 42-year-old Matthew Ciancio.
I watched him dangle under his canopy, unresponsive, not trying to fight it, and just tumbled down and down.
Gwillen Hewitson was on the same flight Wednesday. He described watching Ciancio spiral out of control.
10 or 15 feet from the ground, he finally cut away from his mane, which suggested to me that maybe he was unconscious for most of that. Came to consciousness not knowing what was happening and instinctively went to his emergency procedures, but by then it was too late.
The two have been flying together in their wingsuits for more than 2 years. Gwillen says his friend was an experienced jumper and believes Ciancio's main parachute may have malfunctioned, causing it to open too fast.
You're going 120 miles an hour, and for that to be stopped in an instant gives your body a huge shock.
Possibly a hard opening of his main parachute. By the time he was able to release the main parachute to try and initiate emergency procedures, he was too low to the ground.
We asked Jim Crouch of the U.S. Parachute Association what could cause a parachute to have a hard opening.
More than likely it was an error in the packing or possibly his body position as he deployed.
Crouch says it's uncommon for a hard opening to knock a skydiver out. A killer hobby where one wrong move by even the highly experienced is all it takes to go down.
Accidents happen and the results of them are unfortunately often fatal.
Now the FAA is investigating Ciancio's parachute for any indication of a malfunction. Officials are also looking into Ciancio's certification and whether his parachute fell under federal guidelines.
All right, Angela, thank you very much. Live for us tonight in Ocampo. It's now